And the Russian word of the day is dacha. Repeat after me, dacha. Dacha means, well, there is no exact English equivalent. At least I don't know of one. It kind of means summer house. It means like a house away in the country. Yes, many Russians grew up as children going to the dacha. Dacha is where usually your бабушка and дедушка would take you in the summer and in the winter as well. And this is where you would go collecting mushrooms and berries and you went fishing. And usually there would be like a lot of nature and the creek and the river and the pond and maybe a beach where you were hanging outing with your friends, catching little лягушки and головастики, frogs and tadpoles and, you know, the simple pleasures in life. I guess the origins of this is that when in Russia, especially in the Soviet Union, many people in the big cities, they lived in those big buildings, and so they were longing to be in nature, and also they were longing to have something of their own, even if it's little. You know, because Bolsheviks did away with the private property, therefore the apartment you lived in belonged to the government, but your dacha, even if it was tiny, even if it was pretty crappy, it didn't have running water, it was your very own place. Also, this is where you would have your огород, in the yard you would grow vegetables and berries, because the бабушка would collect them and make canned vegetables and pickles and all of that kind of stuff. So dacha is more than a word for Russians. Dacha is a state of mind. Dacha is a happy place. Dacha is where your бабушка and дедушка are still alive and you're young and you have your whole life ahead of you and you have your happy childhood. So repeat after me. Dacha. Again, dacha. Even my son can say dacha. Son, say dacha.
Dacha.
What does dacha mean to you?
Isn't it like a summer house? You get to play outside with sticks and stones, bathe in the creek, and enjoy yourself in the summer and not do anything.
Pretty much.